Hi, I'm Travis from TMK Interactive, and today I'm going to show you how to find backgrounds for your next show, tweak them visually, and then split them for use as a virtual background. If you're new here and love creative and interactive technologies just like I do, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on any of the fun. This past year, we have all seen shows in varying formats, most of which have been online. One of the most powerful tools that we have when using Zoom or a similar streaming service to stream our shows is virtual backgrounds. This allows us to get some sense of location and scenery. There are lots of places where we can start looking for backgrounds for our next show. Online, there are many sites that sell pre-made backgrounds, and these are a good option if you have it in your budget and are short on time. However, if you are feeling a little more adventurous and want to save some money, you can use your own creativity to create exactly what you envision. This doesn't necessarily mean creating everything from scratch, but rather selectively using the internet's resources to your advantage. The first step is to make sure that you have a list of all of the backgrounds that you wish to have in your show. Be sure to take note on the location and the time of day. There are two main approaches to backgrounds, which is photorealistic ones and stylistic ones. Personally, I'm a huge fan of the stylistic designs, particularly because I'm not very good at making realistic ones. But don't let my limitations persuade you from limiting yourself. First, let's turn to the internet to give ourselves a good head start. There are many websites that allow us to search for images and videos that we can use for our show. One of the most important things that we need to be careful of is finding the images that we have the rights to use. We can't just copy any image off the internet and use it in our show because we could be violating someone else's copyright. Thankfully, there are many websites that offer free images that we are able to use. Some of the websites I commonly use are Pexels and Unsplash. You can also use Google Images, just make sure under the search settings that you selected either Creative Commons or Commercial Use. This will filter out any of the images that we are unable to use for our show. We also want to add some effects to our image to tweak how it looks in order to fit our scene more accurately. There are many software tools on the market to do this, including Adobe Photoshop, Affinity Photo, as well as many other paid programs for photo editing. However, we are going to be using a free open source software called GIMP, which will allow us to edit our photos for free. You can find the link to the download page in the description below. If you want to follow along, go ahead and download GIMP as well as an image you would like to edit. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. I have already downloaded the GIMP software and I have installed it on my computer and I have opened it. I have also found an image online that I want to edit. And for this, we're going to be using a picture of a forest and make it kind of like a mystically night-ish looking forest. And we're going to then learn how to sort of add some effects, mess with the color, and then split it and export it for use, whether it's a virtual background for a stage show, or if you're using a virtual distance show still, we'll learn how to split it up into one so that you can load into, say, Zoom. So I'm going to navigate to my file browser and find the photo that I downloaded, which is right here. And then I'm going to drag it on top of the program. And I'm just going to click on Convert. Once I do that, we will see the image appear in the software. And I'm just going to keep this one short and simple and just show you the bare minimums that you need to know. Let me know in the comments if you want me to go into details about all the tools and features that this program has. But first, I'm going to go and we're going to mess with the colors. So if you go up to the top menu and click on Colors, it'll bring down this drop-down menu. And there's lots of different settings here. The first one I like to usually play around with is the saturation. And saturation is basically how much color and how intense the color is in an image. So if you were to take the scale and bring it all the way down to zero, this would make it a black and white image. And I use this all the time for shows that require black and white images that I can't find one for. But since we want this to be really more vibrant and colorful, I'm going to take the scale and I'm going to move it up until we get a nice saturated image. And once I'm satisfied with it, I will click on OK. The next thing I want to show you is sort of how to nudge your colors in the image one direction or another. If we're going for a night scene, we know that it's going to be a little more blue and a cool color as in terms of like lighting. So to do that, once again, we'll go to the Colors menu, and we're going to go down to the Curves. And what this will do is bring up a curve graph, and this will allow us to nudge either the total image's brightness in particular regions, or choose a red, green, or blue channel individually. So if I were to look at this, at the very upper right-hand corner right here, this is the brightness of the highlights of the image. So the brighter parts of the image, if I take this and bring it down, the lighter parts of the image will get darker. Likewise, if I take the dark parts, I can bring it up. So if I were to take this and make it a horizontal line, you just end up with something very, very washed out and gray, essentially, because you have no differentiation in values. And you can also click in the middle, and you can drag this curve in one particular direction. If you want to emphasize on the highlights, you can bend it up, or if you want to emphasize on the low ones, you can sort of bend it down. For me, I'm going to keep it in the middle. We can do this for individual colors as well. Since we're going to make it sort of a night scene, we can take the blue color, and let's go ahead and make it more blue, essentially. And this is going to be very stylistic. It's not going to look like it's night, but it's going to have a very similar feel to it. So we can go ahead and play around with this. And if we want to raise the blue levels, we can raise the blue a little bit, and then we want to lower everything else. So likewise for red, I'll come here and I'll pull this down. Now we'll see it get greener. And lastly, if I take the green and pull this down, we'll see that we now have a very mystically looking forest. It's quite saturated. The trees are blue. The ground is still green. And you can really play as much as you want to sort of get the look and feel that you want for your scene. I'm just going to accept this and hit OK. And last but not least, my most favorite tool to ever use on images is the blur tool, because I don't know why, I just like soft images that are consistent across, and that really, I've just used it and I like it personally. But if you don't like blur, you don't have to use it. But if you want to, we can go up to filters, and this program has all sorts of blurs. You can choose any of these, and it also, there's a lot of other features like enhance, distorting the image. You can add some artistic features like making it look like a cartoon. There's pretty much endless possibilities with editing your photo. But for me, I'm going to choose Gaussian blur. And this is where we can sort of give our image this clean look, in my opinion. Where if it's behind, I guess I should explain my rationale. If you have a background that's right behind someone and it's very saturated, the person's going to blend into the background. It's going to be very distracting from your performer. So by adding a blur, it sort of gives this dimension. It will almost make your performer look like they're popping out of the screen a bit, and that's usually a good thing. So I'm just going to add some blur until I'm happy, and you're free to do whatever amount you prefer. And I think I like that. And so I'm going to click OK. And now we have this very blurred, stylistic, kind of night-ish, but not really, with blue trees. It's actually kind of looks like something you'd see in Alice in Wonderland. And now, if you were to be doing this for a normal theater show, you would just, this is your image, and you would be able to project this on your backdrop, and you would have a digital background. But say we're still doing shows in Zoom, and you need to divide this up, because each person has an individual square. You could give this image to each person to load in, but sometimes it's nice if you have individual squares to give them a quarter of this image, so when the squares are together, it looks like they're all kind of in one area. And to do that, we're going to use what are called guides. So I'm going to click on the image menu up here, and I'm going down to guides and new guide by percent, and this will allow us to create a guide based on the percentage of the height and the width of the image. So first I'm going to create a horizontal guide at 50%. So horizontally it'll be 50%. And there's that. And I'm going to go up to image again, guide again, new guide by percent. And this time we're going to switch this to vertical and we'll keep it at 50%. And what we've done is we've divided this into four equal portions. If you wanted more, you could just add more guides and evenly space them. And last but not least, we need to now slice the image using these guides. So essentially we want to take a razor and trace the guides we just made and slice them into four images. And thankfully it's very easy. We just go up to the image menu once again and we can say slice using guides. And what this will do is it will now give us four images, which we can toggle through here at the top. Here's the first image, here's the second image, the third image, and the fourth image. And last but not least, we need to export these images. I will start by exporting the full image. And we just need to go up to File and Export As. And I will just name this Full Export and Export. And then I will go ahead and I will click over to the next one. This is our first image. I will do the same thing. Export As. I'll call this one. Click on export. Click on export. And you get the drift of things. You would just go to all of the images that you have sliced and you would just give them a unique name and export them all. Congratulations! You have just created a simple virtual background for your next show. If you liked the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and I will see you next time.